Alright, welcome back to the same training series. So this is a part 4 of this training, okay? This is a part 4 of it. I have done the part 1, which is the general introduction. Part 2, the gig setup. Part 3, the same gig setup again. Now part 4, we are still going to continue from where we stopped. So right here, we move on to description, describing your gig. Just like I told you, all you need to do is you go back again to about this gig. Okay, from the same, let's say the mentor, the person we are following, you copy again. Then you go back again to this. Then you do what? You paste about your gig. So he is offering 10% discount. Now 10% discount from your money, meaning you are going to remove like a $0.5. Okay, so now we stand there, that will not disturb your work for the first order. So you move on. Now we have done that. Frequently asked question. Is there any frequently asked question? Now you check, is there a frequently asked question about us? This about us, then. Okay, there is no frequently asked question. He didn't put that. So since he didn't put that, you leave that one out again. You move on, save and continue. So the moment you save and continue, you can see it. Now tell your buyer what you need to get started. Structure your buyer instruction as free test, a multiple choice question or file upload. Now what do you want the buyer to know before you get started with the job? The first thing can be to contact you. Okay, now you check out again. Is there any other thing again about us? Okay, about our service. Any other thing? 1 day delivery, 5 revisions, proofreading and all this, then. Nothing else. So, that's all. If there is anything requirement, you put it there. Since there is no requirement, you must add at least one requirement. So you can just put this. If there's any other one, answer type, attach file. Okay, you can attach file, it cannot be mandatory. So now you click on this, must at least one requirement. You must add at least one requirement, attach file or free test. Free test. Requirement number. Send the document. Then. Okay, add. Alright, now we've done that. You click on save and continue. So the moment you click, you can see the changes have been saved. Then build your gig gallery. The gallery, the picture and all that. Do you have photo about the previous work or video, anything? You can see photos of people and so on and so forth. So any of these photos you can select, or you add your own photo. Just browse. Whatever you want, your teammates. You can just add a photo. Okay, just put any photo of your choice. The minimum image size. So you change the image size. That one is too short. You look for a bigger one. You can either put your own image, the same thing. So you look for a larger one. Do I have image here again? Let me assume this. The same thing. Okay. Image dimension must be 550 width and 370 height. Now, the image direction, the image you want to use now, is complaining that it is too small. So what do we do to increase the image size? Now let me show you the software we use to edit image to increase the size. So right here, now the software I use is called Photoscape. Okay, if you don't have, you can download it free online. You use it to edit images and anything you want to add text or increase the size, then you do that with it. So right here, we wait for it to load. The moment it finishes loading, then I will do what? Edit it in your presence. You can see I'll just click on editor, edit image. Then I will select the image I want to edit. From here, do I have any image I can edit? Let me look at this. Okay. Now this is 2 something. So we'll make sure we increase it to like 600. So right here, we have the image. Let's say I want to put this now. The next thing I do, I click on objects. Okay, from home, look at it. You click on resize, resize image. Then let me change it to 600 by 390. You can see. I click on OK. Can you see it now? So I save. Then I check another one again. Another teammate. What is the size? 1002. It's alright. Okay. So now that I've saved here, I will now go back and select the image I want. I select the image. You can see it, I've accepted it. Select another one. Another image again. So any image, where is the second image that I edited now? I hope you understand what I'm doing right here. Okay, so let's assume this, if it will accept this. Okay, it have accepted that too. So that is it. So as much as you can, you add any amount of image. Then video. Do you have any video that talks about this gig of you writing and the number of years of experience and thereabout? If there's anyone at all that you have, you just put it. Okay? The moment you put it again. So, if you want, you can also take a risk. If you don't have video, you create another person's video. You can search a video from somewhere. Let's say video. I want to upload my own video. Let me choose if there's any video that will talk about this. Now look at this one. I downloaded this from that same man. So you open and upload it. This is the video of the same person that owned this particular gig. All right. So, but I don't advise you use his own video because the video is showing his own picture and everything. Okay. So you use your own video. Just record a short video about it. If you don't have video, you forget about it. Okay. Forget about it if you don't have. So if you have video already about that, then you put it. So you can see the man video is here. So everything you want, you go back there, you see. So if you see his own video, his images, you can see them, everything. So this is his own video. If you play his video, how do you get the video? If you want to use his own video, you can go to YouTube. I think this video is on YouTube. You open the YouTube link and you download it. When you download it and you upload and you move on, all right? So right here now, the man may claim a copyright to that particular video that I'm uploading. Video under review. Can you see? Please note, this may take up to 24 hours for them to review the video. So you can see the name of the person has already appeared. So I can as well do what? Delete it or put another video. Where is the video? Now delete. Because this video already has somebody's name. You can see the gig. Okay, so later on I can add this. I can add this later, then I will continue. Now let's move on. Gig PDF. Do you have any PDF you want to? I recommend adding a PDF file if further certify clarifies the service you will provide. Nothing, just save and continue. So the moment you do this, save and continue, check if there's error. Nothing there. Almost there. Let publish your gig and get some buyer rolling. Now finish. That is all. You have completed the job. Now your gig, your first gig is up and running. So the next other gig that you want to create, just follow the same process. You do some, you know, modification to your own gig, and that's all. It is up and live. So you can see our study shows that promoted gigs are 3 times more likely to sell. You share your gig on groups, share it, okay? So you go to Facebook group, Twitter, LinkedIn, anywhere. Let your friends, let people know about your gig. You can advertise it on Facebook so that you can get more sales and make more money. So in group, I click on what? Any group at all. So you select your group, you share it. Can you see? So you do it more to as many group as possible. All right? So people will comment. Those that will give you job will give you the job. All right? So you click on this again, select another group, then you publish it again. Straight it will go. Is that clear? This is just how we do it. All right, now view all your courses. Take your gig to the next level, product and so on. Just click on done. We are done, and that is everything, how to set up your gig. Now, we are working on getting your gig impression. Click and view back online. No worries, your gig are active, and all the metrics are calculated as usual. All right, so your gig is now up. You have active gig is 1. You can see it. Translate from English to any listed language, vis-a-vis, okay, or vis-a-vis. So that is it, and this is your impression, click, review order, and so on. Nobody has done anything yet. So the moment they start buying and giving you work to do, you see it, all this metric will start changing. Is that clear? Thank you for watching my video. Please, if you have any question, don't hesitate, okay? Locate the comment box below, and then you send me whatever message, anything, anywhere that you're finding difficult to do, let me know. If you follow the instructions step by step, everything I just did in this video, you will get your gig listed, as many gigs as possible, any niche at all that you want, you'll get. So if you have any question, please like and share this, go to the comment box below, enter this, and make sure you subscribe to this channel. All right, thank you, and remain blessed. Now let's go back to what I want to tell you about this. So there are other gigs which you can work on, not only this translation work, okay? There are so many other work. You can just think of anything you like. Just think whatever you can think about. Now let's assume you want to choose which other work can you do again. Is it only translation? You can talk about lead. You can talk about sending, helping people to do what? Offer what to call virtual services. Okay, let's look at it. Virtual assistant, you can see it here. Virtual assistant for data entry, administrative virtual assistant, personal virtual assistant, virtual staging, assistant on Amazon, and so on. Anyone you want to do, just look at this. The moment you search for virtual assistant again, then you see all the people that are offering the service. Look at them. I will be your virtual assistant for data entry. You can see this person has sold 1,000 plus gig. Can you see it? At the rate of what? $10. Just to, now it's a level 2 seller. Open this person's profile again. You see the job this person have done. Just for $10, within 2 hours work. You can see, starting from $10, can you see a very young girl? Now, look at from United States. You see the gig. Need a lot of data entry work done. Stop relying on luck to get quality freelancers and hire me. I provide high quality virtual assistant. Just follow the same process. Can't you do data entry? Somebody will just send you some document and ask you to go to maybe sort some files. For instance, now, if you check my Facebook page, I did something. I was so busy as I yesterday. I needed some assistance, somebody to do the work for me. But as you mean, I needed to pay somebody to do it. I'll just get somebody to, okay, I'll give the person, go to social place. There is a post I did here. Search everything like this. You can see all the comments, mention you in the comment. People did. So I need somebody to work on this. This is a kind of virtual assistant. You tell them, you offer the virtual assistant on Facebook, on any page at all. All right? So there are so many things you can do. Thank you for watching. Remain blessed.